Now, this is what the ascent profile looks like on a on the Aries 1. You light off the single solid, and that's the five-segment variant of the what flies today. And it flies for about 2 minutes. And then when it burns out, it drops into the ocean. It's recovered. It parachutes in. It is recovered by the divers and towed back, refurbished, and reused. Then the second stage is ignited. Second stage burns to the orbital insertion point. A few of the parameters of the trajectory are pointed out there. I mentioned that it's going to come off the pad pretty briskly. It's going to have about 3.2 million pounds of thrust. And so it's going to have a thrust to weight of about 1.57, I think more precisely. And that's going to cause it to come off a little quicker than Saturn V did. It was, if you ever watched the old Saturn V lift off, it came off very slowly because it had initially about a 1.25 to 1 thrust to weight. And by the time we got to Apollo 17 and we had it loaded up good, we understood our margins better, it lifted off at about 1.17. So it kind of hovered until it burned off some propellants. This is going to come off much faster. It's going to have a much higher dynamic pressure. You notice it's up in the over 700 psi, so it's higher than the Saturn and higher than the shuttle. That is because with the high acceleration of the solid, it builds up its speed much lower in the atmosphere, and it goes by the density of the atmosphere and the square of the relative velocity, so all that results in a lot higher Q than we're used to experience. But we've accounted for that. And then after the second stage lights off, and it has been burning for 30 seconds, it's single J2X engine, and we're confident we've got a good burn. Then at that point, we jettison the launch abort system that had been there to protect the crew. And then it continues into orbit. We insert into a fractional orbit, somewhat like we do with the external tank today. It burns into an orbit that's a minus 11 nautical miles by 100. And then the rest of the insertion is done by the service module of the Orion spacecraft itself. This allows the upper stage then to re-enter into the Indian Ocean, remote area part of the Indian Ocean where there are no shipping lanes. And whether we're flying to space station or whether we're flying lunar missions, one being a due east launch and the other a launch to 51-6, in either case, that orbit allows us to dump into about the same area.